Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, you are all invited. You are all invited by the scripture readings of today to prepare the way of the Lord. I would like to dwell on this theme of preparing the way of the Lord in 5 points. First, the inner way and the outer way. There are 2 ways or 2 roads in our lives, the inner way and the outer way. The inner way is the way that leads to our heart, our life. The outer way is the way that leads to things around us, the crib, the star, the carols, the sweets, the decorations. Ordinarily, we busy ourselves with preparing the outer way. The invitation of the Lord today is to prepare the inner way. Prepare the way to your heart and prepare your heart to welcome the Lord. In Matthew chapter 15, verse 8, Jesus, quoting prophet Isaiah, says, "These people honors me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me." Open your heart to the Lord. Second, turn from your sins. How do you prepare your heart? The first step of preparation is to clean the place, to remove the dirt. This we do by acknowledging our sins, asking forgiveness for our sins, and turning away from sins. In fact, the first word that John the Baptist utters in his sermon in the desert is repent. That is also the first demand that Jesus makes in his public ministry. Repent and believe in the good news. Mark chapter 1 verse 15. Jesus came to save us from our sins. The meaning of the name Jesus is God saves. So begin to prepare your heart by repenting. Third, decorate your heart. It is not enough to purify your heart. You need to decorate your heart to receive the Lord. And how do we decorate our hearts? John the Baptist gives us a clue. He says, "Bear fruit worthy of repentance." Matthew chapter 3 verse 8. So, we decorate our hearts by filling it with the fruits worthy of repentance. What are these fruits worthy of repentance? There are many texts from the Bible that we could cite to list the fruits worthy of repentance. But today, I would like to call your attention to what St. Paul says in his letter to the Colossians chapter 3 verses 12 to 16. Clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other, just as the Lord has forgiven you, so you also must forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. The list that St. Paul gives us is quite big. It calls for diligence, effort, and perseverance from our part. We decorate our hearts by doing what St. Paul has said. Fourth, bear much fruit. How much fruit have you to bear? In John chapter 15 verse 8, Jesus says, "My Father is glorified by this, that you bear much fruit." We have to bear much fruit. Our God is a God of abundance. Jesus says, "I have come that you may have life and have it in abundance." John chapter 10 verse 10. So also, we must be persons of abundance. We must bear much fruit, abundant fruit. The story about one of the desert fathers called Abba Lot says that he went to Abba Joseph and said, "Abba, I am a simple man. Every day I do a little bit of prayer. I keep the small fast, practice some penance, and meditate for a little while. What else should I do?" At this, Abba Joseph stood up, stretched out his hands towards heaven, and his fingers became like torches of flame. And he said, why don't you become completely turned into fire? It is not enough to do the minimum, burn a little. We must become torches of fire. Fifth, pray for the Holy Spirit and the Spirit's fire. John the Baptist said that Jesus who would come after him would baptize with the Holy Spirit and with the fire. It is the Holy Spirit who formed Jesus in the womb of our Blessed Mother. Pray that the Holy Spirit may come upon you, purify you with His fire, inflame your heart with love for God and others, and let Jesus be born in you this Christmas. Let us conclude praying, Lord Jesus, help me so that I may sincerely and seriously prepare the way to my heart to receive you. Let me remove from my heart everything that is not worthy of you. May there be room in my heart only for you and for that which pleases you. Amen.